Hi everybody. So this is the continuation of the Model 2 in the pre-stress concrete members. So in this I will be discussing about the problems. Okay, so a rectangular concrete beam of 300 mm deep and 200 mm wide is pre-stressed by means of 15 5 mm dia wires located 65 mm from the bottom of the beam and 3 numbers of 5 mm dia wires located 25 mm from the top of the beam. If the wires are initially tensioned to a stress of 840 Newton per mm square, calculate the percentage of loss of stress in the steel immediately after the transfer, allowing for the loss of stress due to elastic deformation of the concrete only. And ES for steel is Young's model for steel is 210 kN per mm square, and Young's modulus for concrete EC is equal to 31.5 kN per mm square. If they are not given in the problem, you have to assume that. Okay, then given one note is there: if wires are initially tensioned to a stress of 840 Newton per mm square, calculate the percentage loss of stress in the steel immediately after the transfer. Okay, at P 840 Newton per mm square. Okay, so if they are in the problem, they are given the number of bars or area of the bars, then P will become the P initial. Pre-stressing force, that whatever they are given P, that is 840, it will become P initial. If you multiply with that P with the number of bars or area of steel, then it will become P final. Okay. So given breadth is 200 mm, depth is 300 mm. Okay. So wires located at 15 numbers, 5 mm at 65 mm. Okay. From the soffit and 25 mm from the top. Okay. So because here we are having the wires at top and the bottom. We are having the wires at the top and bottom. So if the wires are placed at the same distance, there is no problem. So if here in this problem the wires has been placed with different positions. Okay, see here. So this is the breadth of the beam and this is the depth of the beam, that is 300, and 200 is the breadth of the beam. So from the top it has been located 25 mm and from the bottom it has been located 65 mm. Okay, so we need to find the centroid of the wire, that is given by y equal to 15 number of wires located into 65 mm from the bottom plus 3 numbers of wires located at 275 mm from the top, divided by number of wires, that is total number of wires 15 plus 3. So 15 bottom, 3 top. Okay, so we are going from bottom. Okay, so this is 65, no problem, and this is the CG, that will be present 150 mm from the top and bottom. So this 275, 300 minus of 25, that will top 5 wires, that will be from the bottom. If you go, so from here to here it is 300 minus 25 means it will be 275. So if you calculate, that will be 100 mm. Okay, the eccentricity is equal to E equal to, so 150, 300 divided by 2 is nothing but 150, half of the beam. Okay, that is 150 minus of 100, this y will give the E, that is 50 mm. Okay, now you have to calculate area of concrete. Area is 200 into 300, that is 6 into 10 raised to 4 mm square. Then pre-stressing force P equal to 840. So as I said initially, if they gave the area or number of bars or area of steel, then you have to multiply that with the pre-stressing, that is P 840 into, so 15 plus 3 is 18 number of wires. So for 5 mm dia, area of one wire is 19.7. so together it will be 3 into 10 raised to 5 Newton or 300 kilonewton. Okay, so next, stress in the concrete at the level of the wires at the top. That is nothing but P by A minus P E by Z. Here it is P by A minus P E by Z. So P is, here you calculate, it is 300 into 10 raised to 3, okay, kilonewton. P by A is 6 into 10 raised to 4 minus P is 3, again 300 into 10 raised to 3 into E is 50 into, that is Z is equal to C here, that this Z I counted into, Z is equal to I by Y. So I is equal to BD cube by 12, that is 45 into 10 raised to 7, then Y is equal to, that is here it is 125, okay, Y is means, so from 150 to, so this is half of the beam, that is 300 divided by 2, 150 by 150, where CG will be lying, okay, then 150 minus of 25 will give the 125, that is nothing but Y, okay. So coming to the next, so stress at the bottom wire equal to, at the top it will be P by A minus as in previous, so at the bottom it will be P by A plus P by Z, okay, that is equal to P by A plus P by Z, that I counted into I by Y, okay. So P is again 300 into 10 raised to 3 divided by area 6 into 10 raised to 4 plus of 3 into 10 raised to 5 into 50 into 85, so 85 means 150 minus of 65, okay, see this bottom. So here 150, half of this neutral, below the neutral axis and above the neutral axis, okay, so 150, 85 is 150 minus 65, because it wires has been located 65 mm from the bottom, so it will be 85, so stress will be 7.85 newton per mm square. Then modular ratio is alpha c is equal to es upon ec, that is equal to 210 into 31.5, that is 6.68, okay. Therefore, loss of stress in the wire at the top is 6.68 into 0.83, that is 5.55. Then loss of stress at the bottom is 6.68 into 7.88, that is 52.5 newton per mm square. Therefore, percentage of loss stress at the top fiber is, that is here 5.55 divided by 840 into 100. So 5.5 is loss of stress at the top fiber divided by initial stress, that is not final stress, it will be initial P, that is P 840, that is 0.66. Therefore, loss of stress obtained from the bottom fiber is, so it is 52.5 here divided by initial stress 840 into 100, that is 6.25%. Okay, coming to the next problem. Okay, a post tension concrete beam 100 mm wide and 800 deep is pre-stressed by 3 cables each with a cross-sectional area of 50 mm square and with an initial stress of 1200 newton per mm square. All the 3 cables are straight and located at 100 mm from the socket of the beam. If the modular ratio is 6, calculate the loss of stress in the 3 cables due to elastic deformation of the concrete for only following cases. So a case A, that is case A, simultaneously tensed and anchoring the cables, and B, successfully tensioning and of the 3 cables one at a time. Okay, two conditions are given. If the wires are simultaneous tension, means all the wires are, if I pull, then what will be the loss? If I pull the wires one by one, then what will be loss in that member of the cable? So given is B is equal to 100 mm, D is equal to 300 mm, then area of steel is equal to 50 mm square, okay. Then so as it is, they are given area of steel, then P, pre-stressing force P becomes P initial, that is 1200 newton per mm square, then alpha is 6, P final is equal to 50 into initial stress, that is 1200, that is 16 into 10 raised to 3 newton, that is 60 kilonewton. Then area is 3 into 10 raised to 4, that is nothing but 100 into 300. Then I is equal to BD cube by 12, that is 225 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 5. Okay, Y is equal to 50 mm. Okay. Therefore, stress in the concrete at the level of the steel can be calculated, that is Ft equal to P by A plus PE by Z. Okay. P by A plus P by Z, that is given by 2.7 into 10, 2.7 newton per mm square, that is equal to P by A plus P by Z, that is equal to P by A plus P by Z into Y, therefore Z is equal to I by Y, okay. Then case A, simultaneously tensioning and anchoring three cables will be, there will be no loss due to elastic deformation of the concrete. If the wires are tensioned simultaneously, then there will be no loss. Okay. So case 2, when the cables are successfully tensioned, okay, then there will be loss in the, there will be no loss in the initially in the cable 1. If cable 2 is tensioned, there will be loss in the cable 1. If cable 3 is tensioned, there will be loss in the cable 2 and cable 1. Okay. So as it is given, the loss of stress in the cable is equal to alpha C into FC, that is alpha is 6 into 2.7, that is 16.2 Newton per mm square as of above. Then cable 3, when cable 3 is tensioned and anchored, there will be loss in cable 1 and cable 2, that is given by, so cable 1 is 6 into 2.7, initial stress alpha into initial stress, that is 16.2 Newton per mm square, and cable 2 is 6 into 2.7, that is 16.2 Newton per mm square. Okay. Therefore, total loss of stress due to elastic deformation concrete is cable 1 is 16.2 plus 16.2, that is 32.4 Newton per mm square. When cable 3 is tensioned, then 16.2, that is when cable 2nd is tensioned, when cable 3rd is tensioned, there will be no loss. Therefore, average loss of stress considered at all the cable is 16.2 Newton per mm square. Thank you.